everyone, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're a returning subscriber, I just want to say thank you to Maiza for coming back. And if you are new to my channel, hello, hi, my name is Amumu Ahi, and I hope you love it here and that you show me your love by clicking the red subscribe button down below. So guys, today I just wanted to chat to you guys about something that I've been doing a lot of thinking on. And I've got my notebook here because, yeah, sometimes when I just have too much on my mind, it's better for me to write things down, you know, just so my head doesn't explode. Or I tend to, like, you know, sit around people and go deep in thought, so I'm just trying to avoid doing a lot of that. So you will see me refer to my notes quite a lot because I feel like I've poured out my heart a lot into stuff that I actually want to chat to you guys about in this book, so do bear with me. So I just want to talk about how, like, when you are a mom, right, especially first-time mom and a single mom at that, at the cherry on top, a lot of things your mind tends to shift a lot from your dreams, if I should put it that way, from a lot of your dreams, your plans, your aspirations in life. A lot turns to shift, and I just wanted to get into that, you know, as to whether, you know, whether or not, I don't want to say if it's something that should be a concern or something we should embrace. I'm not really sure, but, you know, let me just get right into this conversation so that you guys get where I'm going with this conversation, right? So, you know the saying that if your dreams don't scare you, then they are probably not big enough. A big part of me feels like when you are a mom, that statement becomes your, I don't want to say not important, but I feel like it becomes almost sort of like null and void, because the natural thing that we turn to shift towards is basically, you know, putting your child's needs first before your own. It is, you know, and which ultimately then means that some dreams get to be put on hold, but not necessarily forgotten, right? I feel like they shouldn't be forgotten. Sorry, I'm really, like, still, like, deep in thought, but it's really important for me to have this conversation right now when it is still so fresh in my mind and in my heart, right? So I feel like when you're a mom, it shouldn't really become null and void. It should still be valid, especially because, you know what, I don't think you want to one day, well, at least let me speak for myself, I don't want to one day look back or rather have a conversation with my daughter and say that, you know, I wanted to, for example, I wanted to do my MBA, but I put it on hold because, you know, I felt that you were still so young. I had a conversation with my aunt and she said to me that, you know what, Amo, whatever dreams you have right now, when Kumo is still so young, is the best time to do it. What you need to do is to continue giving your child the love and the attention that they need while they are still young, to build a solid foundation of trust, form them that, you know what, mommy's always going to be there regardless of how busy she is, or regardless of, you know, where she is, she was always going to be there. So you're building that strong foundation for them just so you can also go ahead and achieve your dreams. So in my case, for example, my dream has always been to go do my MBA abroad, for example, to one day leave the country and all that stuff. And when I thought about everything at the beginning of the year, I was like, yeah, I don't know if that is still something that I can still do. Let me look back at it in 5 years' time. But the truth is, in 5 years' time, Kumo would have started having, you know, what do you call it? I don't know the scientific term of it, but I don't know if you guys know, but like kids only remember certain things from a certain age. So I think from 3 or 4 years old, they start remembering a lot of the things. Like, for example, if you think about your childhood, chances are that you can only recall back to like when you were 4 or when you were 3 and stuff like that. Hence, doing everything that you need to do, the perfect time is now. When your child, you know, your child won't recall most of the things. So if you want to go ahead and start a new business, for example, you know, leave work and start a new business, now would be the perfect time. Obviously, it has to be a calculated risk, right? Because the comfort in everything is that you have a solid salary. And then when you go and you start your business, you don't know what the turnaround on that is going to be. Is there going to be a return on investment? You do not know that, right? You don't know. And I feel like that's where the whole courage over comfort, or should we call it fear, conversation also comes in. That sometimes for you to get that biggest achievement that you are dying of having, it's by taking, or rather making, the hardest decision in your life and taking the biggest risk ever in your life. And I don't want to say hope that it will work out, but obviously having made that calculated risk, then trusting and believing that it will work out, right? So yeah, that's just, it's just something that has been playing around in my head a lot. And I know that I'm not the only one thinking about it. Hence, I thought that let me just talk to you guys about it. Another thing that we need to remember is that the older your child becomes, right, the more expensive everything becomes. There's things like childcare to consider, and nowadays we want to take our children to Montessori schools, to your Kuros, you know, to your St. John's and your St. Stephen's and all that stuff. And that is all a whole lot of money. It's loads of money. It is loads of money, which is something that you are not spending right now. Right now, as you know, when your child is still an infant, what you're spending the most on is, if your child is on formula, it's formula, you know, nappies, baby toiletries, and obviously then if you have a nanny, your nanny as well. And that's not, you know, it's not as big as having to pay school fees. That's like, what, 6, 7, 8, 10K a month, for example. Hence, my aunt was saying that, you know what, Amo, right now is the perfect time to do it. And I think she's speaking from experience because she's got 3 kids, right? The oldest one is 18 this year. The second born, Karabu, is turning 12, I think, this year. And the last born is turning 2 this year. And she's realizing that, you know what, she can't just leave her job. She can't just leave her job and go pursue certain dreams that, you know, that for the first year, or for the first 2 years, i.e. in my case, if I decide that I want to do my MBA, that means that for the 2 years, because it's going to be full time, for the 2 years, I won't have a source of income, right? I will certainly have to rely on like savings and stuff. So she can't do that. She can't solely rely on savings unless she's got like millions that we don't know about. But she can't do that. You know, she's got bills to pay. She has to put a roof over her kids' head. And she is a single parent as well, by the way. She has to put a roof over her head, over her children's head. She has to pay the nanny. She has to pay school fees and all that stuff. So it's a much more difficult position to be in compared to when you are a new mom. But yeah, that's what's been on my head. That's honestly what has been on my head, that, you know, sometimes you just have to put yourself out there. I always say that opportunities won't always come to you. Sometimes you need to go fetch the opportunity yourself. It's not always going to land in your lap. You have to make it land in your lap by putting yourself out there, and that's the only way that you will see a return in your efforts. That's the only way that you will then, you know, be a step ahead or yeah, putting, yeah, you'll be a step ahead in terms of pursuing your dreams. You will just, yeah, have that courage. And I'm not gonna lie, guys, like, these are all, these so many things that I want to do personally that would have been so much easier, obviously, if I did not have Kumo. That's the truth. But then when I chose to have her, I knew for a fact that I will have to, in a way, relook my approach to pursuing my dreams, because I'm not riding solo no more, right? I'm not riding solo no more. I do have to consider her as well. So, yeah, I feel like I might have been mumbling a lot, but I'm glad I had this conversation with you guys. I'm so glad I had this conversation with you guys. I don't know, guys. Please do tell me what your thoughts are by commenting down below. If you like this video and you found it useful for you and close to your heart, please don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed and you keep coming back to this channel and watching my videos, please, please, please do subscribe. I will really, really appreciate it. And I would love to have you in this family. We would all love to have you in this family. We are all nice to each other here. We are kind. Most of us are new moms supporting each other and just giving each other the love. And, you know, it's just amazing. So please do subscribe. Otherwise, that's it for me, guys. I feel like kibotlile, man. But I don't know if kibotlile enough, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know if I have let it all out. But if I didn't, I will probably make another video. But yeah, that's it from me, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. I love you guys. And until the next video.